morning. My name is Loes Opgaffe, and I'm presenting on behalf of my team Dr. Caroline Jeffra and Professor Jill Hilditch. Tracing the Potter's Wheel, TPW, is a 5-year research project funded by the Dutch Research Council and WO. Our project is designed to identify and assess the appearance of the Potter's Wheel as a technological innovation within the Bronze Age Aegean through the integration of experimental, analytical, and digital archaeological approaches. A major output of the project is an archive which captures and shares technologically focused information about forming techniques for archaeological and experimental ceramics. From the outset, our archive was designed to assist and enhance the project research, while simultaneously sharing our data and knowledge with our peers and the general public. We have also grappled with designing relational and contextually rich data storage for 3D models and their associated information, particularly both metadata and paradata. The 3D models created by TPW are an integrated component of the dataset, as much as the photos, videos, and texts. When connected to the other data in the database, we found that the 3D models were not the problem, the viewer was. Our database is therefore not exclusively a 3D archive presenting an exciting 3D collection. Instead, it's an archaeological narrative about past pottery technology and social interaction in which the 3D models are an integral part. This raises an important issue that we would like to address during this roundtable session, namely that 3D models are, without exception, set apart as visual class presented in isolation as 3D collections within projects and project databases. We maintain that 3D datasets should not be presented in a vacuum. A 3D model becomes a meaningful visualization when embedded within its contextual information. If we fail to recognize this, we risk re-establishing ourselves as object-oriented antiquarians. Today, digital 3D technology is applied in virtually every subdiscipline to document, analyze, and represent archaeological data and heritage. Many archaeological 3D datasets are now available online and are often held up as examples of democratization of data and knowledge production. Despite this potential, there are no nationally funded initiatives for managing this type of research-driven 3D data. One notable exception is the Archaeological Data Service, the ADS, which has an embedded 3D viewer similar to 3D Hub, as the same developers are behind it, and provides a highly detailed metadata scheme to record the data retrieval, post-processing, and technical specifications. The ADS does not treat 3D data as a separate class or collection. Instead, it integrates it in a repository and it's flexible in how a project prefers to present 3D data. Although not currently supporting 3D data, the Dutch Data Archiving and Networking Service is very much open to solutions and has become a partner with TPW. Thanks to a small data project grant, DANS is supporting TPW's collaboration with a commercial partner to create a database with a user-friendly web interface. The 3D models in the TPW database are classified as a piece of data relating to a physical object. Our simple solution is to enter the 3D model into a database with the same object ID as the original archaeological or experimental pot. With that ID, it will be automatically annotated and linked to its contextual data. This resolves the risk of isolating the 3D model while preserving the visibility of the technical metadata and paradata about the choices of the archaeological visualizer. This paradata is described in a workflow description of the entire scanning, processing, and post-processing procedure, which includes the choices for particular hardware and software, and their settings and parameters such as decimation algorithms. This workflow is published on the project websites, and video tutorials about specific scanning solutions are in production. TPW is currently using Sketchfab Pro to share and publish the 3D models of the experimental dataset. Although 3D Hub has better functionality for archaeological inspection, Sketchfab works faster in uploading and tagging the models. The Sketchfab models are embedded in the web interface, and the different file formats of the 3D model are provided as download files, such as the original scan data, the exported OBJs, and the simplified OBJs, PLY, and STL files. Together with the technical data, metadata, and detailed workflow description, the transparency of the entire workflow of scanning and file processing is guaranteed, as well as file compatibility and reproducibility of workflows. The ability to reproduce workflows and reuse original files ensures a consistent accuracy of data quality. We should keep in mind, however, whether it is possible to maintain the ideal of reuse reproducibility and data assessment, given that increasing scanning resolutions and computing power regularly render hardware and software obsolete. This means that safeguarding of the contextual data is extremely important, as the hardware and the 3D models can always be replaced. A number of essential functions have proven useful for including models within our archive. This includes tagging and presentation tools, embedded analytical tools, and easy download options. These functions play an important role in allowing users more fully investigate the material based on what they observe in the models and the media shown alongside of them. A 3D model is not self-explanatory. It needs to be tagged to embed it within its contextual information in order to become a meaningful object. Untagged models achieve different aims, uses, and results compared to a tagged model, and remain mute and uninformative. Sketchfab contains user-friendly tagging functionality in which we include links to related data, text, and media within the database and to websites. This enriches the model, making it informative and giving it a meaningful voice. Users can be guided in what to see and thus be informed, in our case, about forming traces. 3D Hub does not have a user-friendly tagging functionality in the same way. In order to tag models within 3D Hub, it is necessary to write code, which is beyond the skill set of many in our field and, moreover, incredibly time-consuming. Standardization in presenting and tagging 3D models is often approached from a technological or developer's perspective. Tagging, however, depends how heavily upon the aims of the visualization, which can be a 3D model of a monument, a multi-layered excavation, or fragmented artifacts. It also depends on many other related factors, from recording to presentation and even teaching. The tagging should be done in any case is beyond doubt, and as it enriches the model and makes it a meaningful scientific representation of archaeological knowledge. Yet, the diversity of tagging and presentation needs for our field make it resistant to standardization. There are a number of analytical tools which archaeologists use in handling objects in person, and some similar functionality is available for interacting with 3D models. Sketchfab's most archaeologically useful analytical tool is the matcap function in the model inspector, which enables turning off the texture to inspect morphological features in more detail. It doesn't have a measure tool, and a sense of scale is only possible if a scale bar is uploaded with the model. 3D Hub, on the other hand, provides a toolkit that enables detailed simulation of the physical analysis workflow. This functionality includes a torch to light parts of the object, an option to turn the texture off, a measuring tool, and the possibility to make sections on different planes. The option to download the 3D models enables users to conduct further offline analysis, as well as to compare the 3D models of artifacts in open source software such as MeshLab. Shape or trace recognition algorithms could be run locally or on downloaded models, as a functionality TPW is currently experimenting with. In particular, the 3D models of singular forming traces of the unique reference collection developed by TPW can be downloaded and 3D printed to function as a physical training set. Users can then inspect the traces in a tactile way, to achieve a better understanding of pottery technology alongside the digital materials showing greater contextual information. Some challenges and solutions for presenting and curating 3D data alongside other types of archaeological data have been briefly introduced here. The 3D models captured by TPW form an integrated part of the multiple datasets represented by diverse media and file formats presented within the database. Overall, our web-based database democratizes archaeological knowledge by opening access to specialized archaeologists, students, and non-specialists alike. The question remains, however, how can we establish a sustainable repository that actively fosters further research by future users? 3D models are exceptionally useful as a means to simulate and stimulate intensive object studies in a field or lab, a point which is reinforced by thoughtful creation of storage and access solutions. For the TPW project, we have ensured that our datasets have met the basic requirements of sustainable archiving, such as catering for data quantity and format, open access, and adequate infrastructure for long-term storage. However, these basic requirements, which many other projects are currently meeting, do not necessarily foster strong interaction by users. Secondly, we sought to push beyond balancing between stability and usability. The commercial platform Sketchfab is dependent upon an economic profit model, whereas 3DHOP requires the continued investment of the Italian state in the European research framework. Add to which, 3D models are a volatile format, where their accuracy relies upon the standards of always changing current technologies. Taking all these uncertainties into account, we contend that the contextual data making the 3D model meaningful should be stable, sustainable, and accessible at all times. For now, we are doing all we can within existing data frameworks by depositing our database with the Dutch National Digital Data Repository DANS, and by listing the objects on the Europeana soon afterward. In supplementing the deposition of datasets with a custom-built, user-friendly web-based database, TPW has forged a strategy which is where integrated data management meets our known project objectives. Our web-based database will promote learning processes of recognizing wheel traces and provide structured onboarding or familiarization for data collection techniques through manuals, learning pathways, and guidelines. One of the project aims has been to stimulate research into how pottery wheel technology spread across the Aegean over time. Our major task now is to advocate for others to make use of and ultimately contribute to our archive. We want to train other specialists to recognize and interpret evidence for pottery production technology, as well as encourage the gathering of further data on this topic. We can reach potential users of the archive by presenting in specialist sessions on digital pottery archives, but we will also widen engagement with general users through other means, such as interactive museum exhibits and online activities. By using a simple embedded viewer with integrated features alongside wider contextual information of TPW datasets, and enabling multiple download files, the 3D reference collection has a special role to play in helping users transition into a role of a specialist in an interactive and even tactile way. Thank you. Any questions?